Let's do a quick conversion of a 10 mg per ml bovine serum albumin solution as a percentage. Little backstory, bovine serum albumin is often used as a protein standard if you are doing any kind of assay that requires you to have a known molecular weight protein. It's often used as a blocking agent to prevent non-specific binding of antigens and antibodies when we're doing ELISAs or when we're doing any kind of membrane binding of our proteins so that we can probe for a specific protein, so in Western blots as well. The bovine, of course, stands for cattle. It's often obtained from the blood of cattle and it is a major component of blood. So it's purified from blood. Percent solutions in the lab usually are referring to a standard unit of gram per 100 milliliter. That's the convention. Always gram, 1 gram per 100 milliliter. So our 10 mg per milliliter, therefore, is actually 0.01 gram per ml. Again, a percentage is gram, 1 gram per 100 milliliter. So if we say that we actually have 0.1 gram in only 1 milliliter, then we can scale it up 100 times because we have that concentration in 1 mil. So if we scale it up 100 times, then we can actually see that we have a 1% solution because we have 10 mgs in a milliliter. Okay, let's do that again. So let's say we have a 20 mg per ml solution. What percentage of BSA would we have? So our 20 mg is actually 0.02 gram. Remembering that in percentage, we're always having to deal with gram per 100 milliliter. So we have 0.02 gram in a milliliter. This means that we actually can scale it up once again from the 1 milliliter that we have to the 100 ml that we use by convention to communicate percent solution. And so we see that we actually have 2 grams in 100 ml. And so this gives us a 2% solution. Let's do a third one. I'm going to pause and let you have a go at working it out yourself. Feel free to put it in the comments as an answer. So giving you a few minutes and then let's continue. So 4 mg per ml, as gram is 0.004, and I of course did not do the conversion, verbalize it, but it's actually 1,000 times different. So 4 mg is divided by 1,000 to get the 0.004. And once again, this is per milliliter, but to express it as a percentage, it's per 100, so we can scale it to a per 100 amount, and so we can multiply it by 100 since we actually have 0.004 gram in 1 milliliter. And so that gives us a percent solution of 0.4 grams per 100 ml, so 0.4%. You notice I didn't bring in any formulas because I found out the hard way that introducing formulas for myself was just complicating matters. I prefer to just think logically through what I'm trying to do. And so that brings us to the end of this video. If it was helpful, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. If you're a subscriber already, hey, thanks for checking it out. And I'll catch you in the next video. God bless. Bye.